The July 14, 2020 meeting of the Rockingham County Planning Board will come to order. The chair recognizes Mr. James Harris for our invocation.
Let us pray. Most gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the opportunity we can assemble ourselves for the June Rockingham County Planning Board meeting. Just be with us tonight. Lead, guide, and direct us. May the case be presented to us, be understood, reviewed, and properly handled. And we ask these things in your precious name. Amen.
Amen. Have all the members received a copy of the minutes from the June 22nd meeting? I'd like to point out one correction. Item 3, attendance. We need to add the name James Harris.
Mr. Chair, I make a motion that we accept the minutes as written with that one correction.
Second. Motion has been made and seconded to accept the minutes as written with the addition of that one correction. All those in favor, please signify by raising your right hand. Opposed, like sign. The minutes are approved by a unanimous vote of 6-0.
Mr. Chairman, I just wanted to make a correction, too. I had indicated a June meeting and then July.
You're forgiven, James.
I was just a little slow getting there. Amen.
The following are the guidelines for speakers at tonight's meeting. Any and all persons who would like to speak regarding any case being heard by the Planning Board must sign the case file roster prior to the beginning of the meeting. Each speaker, we'll skip that part, you don't need to be sworn for this meeting. Each speaker must be recognized by the presiding board member prior to speaking. Unless otherwise specified, all testimony, evidence, and comments should be directed to the board chairperson or presiding board member. Each case will be presented to the board by a member of the planning staff. Following the staff presentation, the case applicant will be given the opportunity to brief the board regarding the case. Following the applicant's presentation, those who have signed up to do so will be granted the opportunity to speak against or in support of the proposal. If needed, the board chairperson reserves the right to set time limits for each speaker. After the public comment period is completed, the applicant will be given the opportunity for rebuttal. This will be followed by board discussion, motions, and voting. We have one case on the agenda for tonight, case number 2020-17. Staff will make a presentation of the facts concerning this case.
Case 2020-17 is a case for a rezoning from a combined zoning of light industrial and highway commercial, highway residential agricultural to highway commercial conditional. So this is a conditional request with use conditions determined. The request is for 10971 US 220 in Stoneville. It was operated as a gas station and grocery store many years ago. I believe the building has been vacant for some time now. This map doesn't show really clearly, the next one does, where the property is located at a, has frontage on both 220 and Business 220. The property's in the economic development land class to accommodate and encourage new industrial and commercial uses in areas where the government supports substantial investments in water, sewer, and transportation systems. This is characterized by lands outside of developed and urban transition areas where substantial capital investments are strongly encouraged to create new jobs and build the county tax base. I believe this property wants to be marketed as a commercially viable property rather than a residential property based on where it's located and its potential. Surrounding zoning, this gives you a better picture of how the property is situated. This is a effect of putting a portrait-sized image on a PowerPoint presentation. Hopefully there's, and I can zoom in on this if we need to for more information. You see there's a building on the property here at the northern end of the property. It was once developed with access from the highway and from the business 29 at the back end. 220, what did I say? 29. No, actually, it is.
220.
It's 220 in Stoneville. Okay. It is 220 and business 220. I may very well have developed. Right. Staff does recommend approval of this rezoning request based on its location and nearby zoning and the land class of the land use plan that it's located within. Are there questions?
Yes.
For me.
Was the residential agricultural zoning assigned to this property before the adoption of the Unified Development Ordinance?
It was an original zoning district, yes.
Okay. So even though a business had been operated there, the Unified Development Ordinance didn't apply?
Correct. Okay. Well, it didn't catch it or didn't, it was never changed. I think the business was in existence before the ordinance, and it was just.
Okay, and to the best of your knowledge, this application is to be able for the owner to convey the property?
That is the best of my knowledge, just for the owner to be able to to market the property as a commercially viable parcel.
Okay. Thank you.
Regardless of that, of course, Paul, it's about whether it's appropriate for the zoning district.
Mm-hmm.
But there is no particular intended use at this time.
Carrie, I have a question. This is 8.24 acres, which is fairly large. On the permit, the permitted uses, you have amusements, outdoors, commercial, marked out. Can you explain why that wouldn't be one of them that this can be considered for?
That's a good, an appropriate question to ask the applicant, is the conditions are initially offered by the applicant.
Okay.
And I'll let him answer. It may have something to do with noise or disturbance to the surrounding area.
Okay.
Any other questions for staff?
Is it correct there's a 1964 Court of Texas card, I guess a block building, is that correct on it?
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know what the intent to develop, whether it would be to use this building or replace it with something else, but that would be addressed with the, submittal and approval of a site plan for development. Yeah, whether it's being reused or replaced, either way it would have to be approved.
Okay, thank you, Carrie.
Sure.
Is the, I didn't get the sign-in sheets.
Is there anyone in the audience who would like to speak who didn't sign up?
Is the applicant here?
He is. Go ahead.
Are you Mr. Evans?
I am.
Would you mind taking the podium, please? You don't need to be sworn in for this, but for the record, please state your name and address.
Clyde Evans, 240 Lester Road, Stoneville, North Carolina.
Thank you. And what is it that you would like the planning board to know about your application?
We basically applied because we would like to, like she said, market the property as commercial, since really it isn't feasible to use it as residential just because of where it's located on the highway, like she mentioned, between the business highway and the interstate. We don't really see it being possible to be used as a residence, especially the building that's there. It's level with the interstate. There's a lot of traffic noise and things like that, so it's not really feasible to use that as a home for anyone to live in.
Do you happen to know the approximate distance between the two roads? It's really sandwiched in there.
I'm not really sure. The front of the property is very close to the interstate, you know, where the main structure is. So.
Yeah. Very unusual shaped piece of land. Not that that means anything.
It's the way those two roads were put in.
Do any of the members have a question for Mr. Evans?
I do, and I'll go back to my original question to Carrie. Uses permitted by right, you've marked out number four, amusements, outdoors, commercial. Was there a reason why you didn't want that considered?
The ones that I crossed out were just ones that, when I kind of went through the list, ones that I thought may be problematic for anyone that lived in that area. I don't live a great distance from there, so I tried to, of course, I would like for it to be zoned commercial for our, because I think that would be appropriate, and mm-hmm. for our, you know, desire to sell the property. But, you know, considering that I live in the area and I know that there are some homes in the distance from there, I tried to delete some of the ones that I thought would be less than desirable due to noise or crowding or things like that.
Okay, thank you.
How far away is the nearest residential property, approximately, if you know?
I'm not really sure. I know that there's one home behind the property that's off of the two lane, the old 220.
Yep.
So I'm thinking that's probably the only one, and that's near more of the where the property really narrows. So I think that's more where it would be less likely for it to ever be developed or used for anything.
Yeah. Okay, members, any other questions for Mr. Evans?
Yes. I noticed recently that that a business has been being operated out of that building. Is that right?
Well, it's currently just used for storage. It's more of a landscaping type person. It's a family member who's storing some things there, and he's a prospective buyer. So, you know, the desire would be that if this were to be approved, that he would be able to do more in the future, maybe like a landscape supply type sales or something like that.
So I guess that would come under RA if it had been operated, because he was selling mulch and he was selling topsoil. And
well, he's not selling anything from that property. He does jobs off-site, to my knowledge.
No. I've called him and offered to buy some topsoil from him.
Okay.
At that particular location, because I live in Stoneville.
Okay.
And I noticed he had a big pile of topsoil out back.
Right.
And he had big piles of mulch, which had various items for sale. So I just wondered if how he was operating as an RA with items for sale there.
Well, to my knowledge, he had just told me that he was just storing some things there. So it's been beyond my knowledge if he's sold anything from the site. I just was aware that he was using it to store equipment and that type of thing.
So, James, the way we treat it is that now that it is, that we are aware that there could potentially be a business being operated there, should the zoning not be successful, we would have to follow up on that. Otherwise, we can say that whatever, if there is a business occupied being run there, it would become more compliant now with the zoning.
Okay.
It would come into compliance should the zoning be approved.
Additional questions for Mr. Evans, if necessary? Thank you, sir.
All right, thank you.
Is Frank Norton here? Sir, if you would, please take the podium.
Okay.
And for the record, please state your name and address.
Frank Norton, 150 Ray Road, Stoneville, North Carolina.
And what is it that you would like the planning board to know about?
I signed it so I could know what's going on and And I've heard everything that's been said, and I don't have any questions.
Okay. Well, you did sign up, so I thought I'd just give you an opportunity. Well, thank you very much. You can be seated if you wish.
We just got this yesterday, about the meeting, so I didn't know nothing about it.
Oh.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Discussion, members?
Paul, if I may interrupt, Emily and Ben both brought up a couple of points. There has been a code enforcement case at this property in the past, just for information's sake. And Emily had a couple of points to answer questions about the width of the property and the proximity from the... from the nearest house.
So just looking at the tax records online, because I can't access those on my computer, it looks like the nearest residence is about 700 feet. And then right where the store is that strip you guys were talking about, how wide is that? That's approximately 400 feet wide. And then, now it wouldn't be permitted, but technically sales of topsoil and things of that nature are allowed in the RA district because it's an agricultural district. Things of or related to plant cultivation are allowed for sales, though it wouldn't have necessarily been permitted. So like Carrie said, it would be the code enforcement issue.
Okay. When was that code violation?
I won't say 3 or 4 years ago.
Oh, okay, long time ago. All right. Any comments, members? If not, we'll proceed to a motion.
Was there another speaker signed up?
No.
Nothing, no others? Okay.
No. Yes, sir.
After reviewing the Highway Commercial Conditional District Zoning Amendment, I'd like to recommend that we approve the amendment as required by North Carolina General Statute 153A-321 and 153A-342. After considering Rockingham County's adopted comprehensive plans, the planning board would recommend approval of case 2020-17. This action is consistent with the adopted Rockingham County Land Use Plan. This zoning amendment supports the intent and descriptions of the urban transition land class. The board considers its actions in adopting the proposed zoning amendment to be reasonable because the proposed use is an appropriate use for the land, considering its effect upon the entire community as a social, economic, and political unit. The size of the parcel is appropriate for the district requested. The property for the request is located between two highways and near other commercially zoned properties. The board considers this action in adopting the zoning amendment to be in the public interest because the proposed development has sufficient design features so as to be compatible with or exceed the quality of existing developments in the neighborhood. The uses permitted in the Highway Commercial Conditional District would have similar impacts as the surrounding residential zoned properties. This would not impose significant harm on the neighbors and surrounding communities. The proposed rezoning is designed to meet or exceed all requirements and goals of the existing UDO in the comprehensive plan. And on the balance of the following factors, the size of the tract in question, the compatibility of the zoning action with the comprehensive plan, the benefits and detriments resulting from zoning action for the owner or the newly permitted property, the neighbors and the surrounding community, and the relationship between the envisioned permitted use and the uses currently present in adjacent tracts weigh in favor of approving the proposed zoning amendment.
I second that motion.
All those in favor, please signify by raising your right hand. All those opposed, like sign. There's no opposition. The vote's unanimous. 6-0. The application for rezoning is approved as a recommendation to the county commissioners, who will have final approval of this recommendation at their meeting on, Carrie?
August 17th.
August 17th.
The second meeting in August.
Do we have any old business to discuss? Any new business to discuss?
Just to point out that we're behind on some of the fee, your salaries. It's not a salary.
No comment.
No comment.
Would that be our pocket money?
It's tempting, but no.
Right in front of the public.
Our pocket money.
Thank you for bearing with us in that. Other than the fact that ONTAX is moving the first installation in the South Rockingham Corporate Park there at 220 and 68, will be breaking ground next month. It's in the work. It's all. This is the most parallel approval process you'll have ever seen. Yeah, equipment will be arriving in the spring, and so they're. But yeah, they've gotten enough of their initial approvals to be able to keep moving. Yeah. Pretty exciting.
The chair will entertain a motion to adjourn the meeting.
Second.
No. Making the motion. A motion has been made, seconded, and thirded to adjourn the meeting. All those in favor, please signify by raising your right hand. Meeting is adjourned.